Active shooters, hostage situations, even bomb threats, SWAT teams train for very serious scenarios, but once a year that training turns competitive. George Colley has that story.
5, 6.
Any team is only as strong as its weakest link.
Down.
Up. But for those on this team, weakness can be a matter of life or death. SWAT units train for all different scenarios, on land or underwater.
Let's go, Nate.
During the day or at night. Once a year, elite law enforcement from across the Northeast descend on Connecticut for the Connecticut SWAT Challenge.
This is a training evolution where we keep score to see who did the best in the training environment. But it's also here for these guys to meet each other, see different techniques, different procedures, see how everybody's doing it around the country.
The first SWAT Challenge was in 2005. It had about 16 teams, mostly all from Connecticut. This year, there's nearly 3 dozen teams from 10 states. I imagine it's pretty competitive.
To say pretty is an understatement. It's very competitive.
In this challenge, the New Haven SWAT team is running into a building that's pitch dark to test its ability using night vision goggles to get a dignitary safely away from a terrorist gas attack.
The training they put on here is phenomenal. It's top notch. Having role player scenarios with simulations, it's as real world as we can get it, you know, and as safe as we can do it.
It's a real world scenario that builds camaraderie amongst the individual units and those they may come across when responding to an incident.
It's extremely competitive, but it's a, you know, it's a brotherhood. Good also to network for the, even the towns that are near us, because mutual aid, these large incidents that we've already had, yeah, these guys are coming. They're the ones we're calling for help.
The Our Heroes Fund sponsors the event. It's a nonprofit that raises money for fallen and injured law enforcement, as well as training and educating officers. George Colley, News 8.